he destroyed the temple. So they came to Babylonia, and they said by the famous rivers of Babylon. You know, anyone knows what are the rivers of Babylon? The Perat, Euphrates, and the Hideke, the Tigris River. So they're sitting by the banks of those rivers. By the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down and cried when we remember Zion. And indeed, the liturgy of the Iraqi Jews that deals with the expulsion and with destruction is very, very, very sad. Very morose. It's so sad that a friend of mine just told me that he visited an Iraqi synagogue in Israel for the first time. He's Moroccan. For the first time, he went to the Iraqi synagogue on Tisha B'Av, where we mourn the destruction. He said, this will be the last time. I was so sad. I was crying. I cannot handle that. So, and I give you a taste of that. When they sing about the destruction, right, they take this song in Tehillim, Al Na'od Babel, by the rivers of Babylon, and they chant it like that. But I don't want to make you sad, so I'm not going to dwell on that. And I think the beautiful thing is that even though they lived with that memory of the destruction, they were able to rebuild their lives, like I said, and be involved in all aspects of commerce and technology and science and the government. And they got to a point that they wrote songs to celebrate life events and happy occasions. And that will be the next song that we're going to perform. It's called Manavu. You see it in that? I want you to learn one line only. Manavu alei heharim raglei bevaser shalom bevinyan erech. Maybe we'll sing it together. So the meaning of those words, how beautiful are the footsteps of the harbinger, the one who is telling us that the Redeemer is coming, and Yahweh the prophet is telling us the Redeemer is coming. And this song is sung at happy occasions, right? There's a bar mitzvah in the synagogue, or the naming of a baby girl, bar mitzvah, or a wedding. They sing this song. It's a very happy song. But it's also accompanied by something called ululation. You know what a ululation is? Okay. So that is basically producing a certain sound that sound like you're saying a long L. Right? You know how to do that? No? Okay, right. Can you do it again? Okay, are you Iraqi? Okay, obviously. So, yeah. The Iraqis know how to do it, the Moroccans know how to do it. It goes like. Okay. My wife isn't better, but she's. There's a legend around it. I don't think that it's true, but they say that when Lavan, the father-in-law of Yaakov, tricked him and gave him Leah instead of Rachel, the people who were there at the wedding were trying to tell him that it's not Rachel, it's Leah. So they're going. But he didn't get it. So that's the story. So if you feel at a certain point during that song that you want to go like. That's what we do in the synagogue. When you start singing that and the person comes down from the Torah, everybody throws candies at them, and it's really, it's a bit of a different candy because you know what is allowed or not. So, but imagine the candy's flying and the kids is collecting them. So, let me work on with you on the first line and see if we can sing it. Manavu ale, let's just say these words. Manavu ale, manavu ale, heharim ragle. Peharim ragle, mevaser shalom, mevaser shalom, bevinyan ilech, bevinyan ilech. Okay, so it's not that difficult, right? So let's sing the whole line. Manavu ale, peharim ragle, mevaser shalom, bevinyan ilech. Again, manavu ale, peharim ragle, mevaser shalom. Shalom,
Thank you.